Last class, what we have discussed regarding regular expression. Okay. Epsilon is a regular expression. Its corresponding regular language is this one. Every symbol A is a regular expression and it is denoted by a symbol. Okay. This is the regular language. Language is a collection of strings. Every symbol is a string. Epsilon is also a null string. And phi is a regular expression. Its corresponding language is this. These three are the base case. Then, if R is a regular expression, corresponding regular language is R, and S is a regular expression, corresponding regular language is S. So, if this is given, then R plus S is a regular expression, corresponding regular language is R union S. RS is a regular expression, corresponding regular language is concatenation, RS. These two languages are concatenated. Okay. R star is also a regular clean closure of R. Its corresponding regular language is this one. And if R is a regular expression, its bracket if you can give, that is also a regular expression. Either you can give a bracket or sometimes bracket is not required. Also. You can, the same thing you can get. Okay. So this is a recursive definition of regular expression and its corresponding regular language, right? So finite automata are connected with regular language. So if you can design a finite automata for a language, that language you are calling the regular language. This is the definition. And regular language, now we have given another definition, regular expression. That means there must be some connection between regular expression and a finite automata. Okay. And in fact, last class I told you that for every regular expression will correspond to a language, a regular expression is given, can we design a finite automata for this? That is the question. So suppose arbitrarily, I can give you one regular expression, zero star is a regular expression. Okay. Zero star plus one is also a regular expression. Right? This is one example. Zero star plus one, if you give a bracket, then this is also a regular expression. Okay, if a regular expression is given, if you just give a bracket, then that is also a regular expression. And followed by, suppose, 1, 0. 1 is a, every symbol, 1 is a regular expression, 0 is a symbol, 0 is a regular expression. If you concatenate them, this is the definition. If you concatenate them, then that will also a regular expression. Similarly, 0 star is also a regular expression by using this. Okay, if you know a regular expression, if you perform the iteration star operation, then that is also a regular expression. Then, so this is a regular expression which I am forming this regular expression using this definition recursively. Okay. So if you can split it, this is one after another, you can combine and you can form this. That is the question. Okay. Now, if this is a regular expression, can you find out a regular language? What is the meaning of this language? Can you open this operation used in regular expression? And its corresponding operation in set theory is union operation, right? So now 0 star plus 1 means this is the 0 star set, 1 is this set. Now you make a union operation. Then 1, 0. If you want, you can also write the set of 1, you can also write the set of 0. Okay. This is regular expression, this is the corresponding set. So that means this set becomes epsilon 0. 1 will also be there, 1, then all other 0s only, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, etc. Okay. So this set you got. Then, you start with 1 0. 1 0, if you want, you can write this way also. You can open it, or if you want, you can also write this. Okay, that means 1 0, you that string you concatenate with every term. Okay, so your final language, if you want, if you write directly 1 0 in concatenation epsilon is 1 0, then sorry, epsilon first epsilon, then this one. Okay, the right side it will be added 0, then 1 0, then 1 1 0, then 0 0 1 0, then 0 0 0, this one, then 1 0. Okay, 4 0, then 1 0. So this is what the 0 star plus 1 meaning is 0. Either 0 star is the all possible strings of this 0, or plus means or a single 1. Okay, when you are padding with 1 0, that means 1 0 is padded to all the terms. 1 0 is padded with all the terms of 0 star, 1 0 is padded with 1. 0 star, first 1 0 you can pad plus 1 1 0. This is also another simple version. Okay, 0 star 1 0. I am not writing this because we have not read the properties. This is one which property? X plus y into z, xz plus yz. The way we know this property, x plus y whole into z is equal to x into z plus y into z. The same property also holds in case of strings. That we know in case of numbers. Okay. So if you multiply x plus y two numbers in our number system, okay, in high school you, all of you are using this x plus y whole into z, but here plus and in number theory plus, that plus is addition, but here this plus means or operation. Okay, either this or this. Okay, or in set theory this is union operation, and here 1 0 is not the multiplication, or this nothing I have written means this is not multiplication, this is concatenation operation. But the properties is similar to our number theory properties. Okay, that's why I can simply multiply. This type of things also you know in Boolean algebra, Boolean functions. For this, someone is asking some another example. Okay, so let's say 1 plus 0 whole star. What is the meaning? This meaning is same as 1 means this, 0 means this one. Okay, every symbol is corresponding language is this one. Plus means union. Okay, so that means is star. Right? So 1 union 0. To set this one. Okay. So if you want, you can give this bracket is not required. Okay. So when both are same. So 1 plus 0 star is the same as 1 0 star, this is sigma star. All possible binary strings over sigma, which we are familiar. Okay. So we are discussing just in a systematic way, you can find out what is the language. Okay. Let's take another example. So all these strings, what we are saying, all these strings end with 0 0 1. 1 plus 0 star means I have written 1 0 star. Okay. All possible binary strings end with 0 0 1. This is another example. Or you can write all possible binary strings. Previously we are writing this way. Okay. But if you want to write in the regular expression form, is another representation is 0 plus 1 star, 0 0, 0 plus 1 star. This is another example. What is the meaning? So this set contains all binary strings where 0 0 is a substring. Left side is any possible binary string, right side is any possible binary string. But 0 0 must be there of 0 1. So this is another candidate. So this is the regular expression and this is the regular language. So every regular expression will correspond to a language and its name is regular language. Okay. Of why you can give another name. Why they have given regular Lagrange? Because of this theorem. Because already we have given a name regular Lagrange. Previously we know what is a regular Lagrange. Means if you can design a finite automata for a language, that language we call a regular language. And the same name we are using in this case also. That means for every regular expression, we can always construct a finite automata. Right? For every regular expression, you can construct a finite automata. So start. This is regular expression. This is finite automata. Directly, in many cases we can solve it directly. Okay, for this one, okay, so you can write q0 and 0, 1, any number of 0 and 1, all binary strings, followed by 0, 0, 1. So q1, q2, q3. Okay, so this is the very simple, all possible binary strings. Then followed by 0, 0, 1. So for this regular expression, I am constructing another finite automata. Okay. For this expression, I am constructing a finite automata. For this expression, I can you construct a finite automata for this one? I think you can try. It's very simple. So because 0, 1 star means you can write down this. This is my final state. Okay, 0, 0, 1. Here, 0, 0, I will write q1, q2, then after 0, 0, then this is 0 plus 1 star, 0, 1. And you can make this as your final step. Now, my question is, if I will give you an arbitrary regular expression, you can concatenate this with all these three, you can concatenate, okay. Suppose 1 plus 0 star, then plus, or make 1 plus 0 star, then 0, 0, 1, then plus, or you can concatenate, you can add 0 plus 1 star, 0, 0, then 0 plus 1 star. So as per my definition, as this is a regular expression, this is a regular expression, so this R plus S is also a regular expression. We have given this definition. Okay, all kinds of operation if you follow, then that will be a regular expression. So now this is a regular expression after addition, right? If this is a regular expression and this is also a regular expression we have seen, so if you again add these two, then that is also a regular expression. Or if you may concatenate them, we can form another regular expression. So how many regular expressions you can construct? How many using this recursive definition? How many regular expressions you can construct? Finite or infinite?
Infinite.
Infinite. So this is a regular expression. You concatenate a symbol. Every symbol is a regular expression. You concatenate another symbol. Or you can make hop plus. You can make again star. So you can always construct a very long expression or a regular expression. Now, this theorem will tell you, will give you an answer, interesting answer, that whatever all such infinite regular expressions, you can always find a finite automata. Now, this is just a specific example. A specific example we have constructed, the finite automata. Randomly, suppose this is one example, another example. It's a very long expression. Now, can you give the guarantee that yes, one finite automata exists? Or if exists, can you find out that finite automata? Right? That's why there is a requirement that to prove that for every regular expression, you must find out a way or give a systematic technique by which, given a regular expression, you can find out the corresponding finite automata. So two things. One is existence. Yes, it exists. And if it exists, find out that finite automata. Or how to find out that finite automata. Okay. So one algorithm exists, which we will discuss today, from regular expression to find its corresponding NFA with epsilon move. Okay, NFA. So this is the algorithm is from regular expression to NFA non-deterministic finite automata epsilon transition. This is actually the theorem. Okay, this specifically I have written finite automata, but the algorithm what we will discuss today, that is given a regular expression, I can find always find a NFA with epsilon transition. Okay, so that we will discuss. Then last class we have shown that NFA epsilon is equivalent to NFA. NFA is equivalent to DFA. Okay, as all these are equivalent, so every regular expression you can always find a finite automata. So this part we will discuss today. Finite automata is given, find its regular expression. That is another class we will discuss. But today we will discuss this part. Okay, regular expression is given. How to give a guarantee that you can always find a NFA with epsilon transition. Okay. It is not always easy. It will not follow a systematic way. You cannot find out a regular expression. You cannot find out a finite automata from a regular expression. Okay. It was, these examples are the simple examples. But now this is, you see, it's a complicated one. Okay. Or arbitrarily, one can randomly give one string. You can also construct one regular expression. And question, or you can pose that find a finite automata for that. Okay, so that's why there's a need to find the finite automata or NFA from regular expression. I am directly solving this here. Okay, is it clear to all? Regular expression is given, how to find its corresponding NF. That is my next, we will discuss that. Okay. If that is clear, the question is clear to you, solution I am telling now. You see, this is the recursive definition. Okay. Recursive definition of regular expressions, right? So if this is my definition and all regular expressions you can construct using these definitions only, that means if I can find out the finite automata for these cases, all of these cases, then I can tell safely that for every such regular expression you can find a finite automata. Are you getting the logic? So this is the definition of regular expressions. All regular expressions is a simple model is this one. If you give any regular expression, you can always construct from the symbol using epsilon, using again, you can concatenate, you can use some operations, you can always construct from the base cases using these operations. Okay. So now only my requirement is find out a machine for individual cases, right? If for these cases I can find out an NFA, then my job is over. Now, because I have already written this, let me write down how to find out the automaton for epsilon. Can you design a finite automata or NFA where its language is only epsilon? Yes, very simple. You write U0 and this is, what is the language of this one? Is it a finite automata? It will only accept epsilon because this is my initial, this is my final, right? So it will accept the epsilon only, right? This is,
yes sir.
This is my epsilon. For A, can you write down Q0, then A, then Q1? What will be, what this machine will accept? What is the language of this machine? Can anyone tell? What this machine will accept? This is the initial state, and by reading A, you are going to a state, and it's a final state. Okay. That means it will only accept A. So the language is this one. And another, suppose Q0, then final is this one. No transition. What will it will accept? What is the language of this third one? It will be empty state. It will not accept anything. There is no transition from Q0 to Q1. Okay. So in some book, the first one, either this one or because machine is not unique. Okay, for one language you can design many machines, many algorithms that you know, because many logics can be possible. Another logic, someone can write that Q0 by giving epsilon, you can go to Q1, because NF epsilon where this one or this one, both are same. Okay. It will accept only epsilon. Okay, and for symbol, this is one machine I have constructed. For empty set, the final irregular expression corresponding NF is this one, right? Now, for R, so it says if R and S are regular expressions, if R and S are regular expressions denoted by R and capital R and capital S, then R plus S, R S, R star, these are also regular expressions. These definitions I have given. Okay. Now, R and S both are regular expressions. Means, and corresponding to regular language R and S. This is given. If R is a regular language, means a finite automata exists for that R. S is a regular expression, both are given. Okay. Then, now, for R plus S, find out a regular NF. So let me write down one machine. Suppose this is my machine for R. Okay. This is my machine for R. This is my machine for, because S is a regular expression, that means one finite automata exists for S, right? Now, so this R is a regular expression. S is a regular expression. Say, this is the regular expression. This is my regular language. Regular expression, and this is my regular language. Okay. And this is my NF. And exact NF I am not writing because I don't know exactly what will be my R. Okay. If R is this one, then NF is this one. If R is this one, then finite automata is this one. Okay. So as I don't know what will be my machine, that's why I have just written in this way. Given R is a regular expression and corresponding NF, suppose this is my NF. Suppose this is another NF for regular language S, corresponding to regular expression small s. Okay. Now, for R plus S, how to find out a regular expression? These two machines you know, smaller machines, you can combine in this way. So, इसका एक इनिशियल स्टेट होगा, इसका एक फाइनल स्टेट होगा, इसका इनिशियल स्टेट, इसका फाइनल स्टेट, राइट? तो यू जॉइन देम बाय एप्सिलॉन, मेक ए इनिशियल स्टेट, जॉइन देम बाय एप्सिलॉन, एंड दैट दिस इज माय फाइनल स्टेट क्यूएन. Okay. Suppose this is for R, this is for S. This is my initial state. from these two machines, you can construct, you can just join them by epsilon transition. So this machine, this NFA will accept R plus S. Its corresponding language, this regular expression corresponding language will be R union S. What is the meaning of R union S? A union B, what is the meaning? So, मुझे ये चाहिए. Suppose this is a regular expression. See this example. Okay, this is one regular expression. Corresponding regular set is this one, and corresponding finite automata is this one. In there. For this one, this is my finite automata. Now, what is the meaning of this plus this R plus S? Means all strings of this form will also accepted. Union means or. Huh? And if you give a string of this form, then that is also accepted. That is my requirement. Okay. Are you getting union? Union means all strings of this form is also accepted by my design a machine, design a finite automaton. It will accept this type of string also, or this type of string. That means input can be of this form or this form. Then my machine will go to the, after processing that, my machine will go to the final state. That is my question. So to do that, what you will, because you know these two machines, the architecture says, the design technique says, you start a new initial state. Suppose this is my R, this is my AS, right? This is for first regular expression, this is for second regular expression. Now, if you join them by epsilon and make another new final state and new final state and join this by new final state, join them by epsilon. That means whenever you give a string of R category, then from initial state via epsilon, epsilon means without looking anything, if your string of this form directly go to this part, this state, then you know that all strings of this form, the corresponding machine, you know that R is the that machine. So it will go, immediately process it and go to the final state. So once it will go to the final state, from that by epsilon, you will go to the final state of the total new machine. This is your new machine. And the final state is this one. Okay. So for new machine, if your string is of R category, then you will follow this path. And after processing that R category string, then you go to the final state of the new machine. That means the new machine will accept all strings accepted by R. In the similar logic, if a string will come in of this category, then you start from the initial state, followed by this epsilon transition, reach at the initial state of the second machine S, then again you follow that, because this is the S category, so you know this is the machine which will process it and it will lead to the final state of S. Okay. But your objective is that your new machine should accept it. That means after reaching here, you have given an epsilon transition, like this one. Okay. So after processing all the strings of S, then you, by epsilon, you go to the final state of the new machine. So this is my new machine, which will accept all strings of R or all strings of S. Is it clear? This is for RS, R plus S. Similarly, next definition of recursive definition is RS is also a regular expression. Okay. And R star is also a regular expression. R plus S, we have constructed this one. For RS, so your construction will be very simple. Suppose this is my R, then this is my S. First you follow all the R strings. Okay. Then you follow, this is the initial state, this is the final state of R. This is the initial state of S. This is the final state of this machine in that. Okay. Now you join them by epsilon. make this is the initial state, and this you can make the final state. So this model, this design will accept all strings of R followed by all strings of S, then you will lead to the final state. Okay. So if you know the machine for one, you know the machine for S, just read them epsilon, then it will be the machine for the new one. And remember that for R, this is the initial and this is my final. For S, similarly, this is one initial must be there, one final must be there, it's a smaller machine. So for every DFA or MFA or NFA, for every finite automaton, there must exist a initial state, also final state. But those final states, I have changed, those may not be the final state here. Okay. Because my new final state will be another one. Okay. Similarly, these two are not the initial state of the R union S machine. My initial state for this one is another state, Q0. Okay. They are not the initial for the larger machine. Okay. Similarly, for RS, initial state is the same, the initial state of R. Okay. And previously, this was my final state of R. Okay. But now this is no more the final state. If you don't make it final state, if you make it final state, then it will only accept R. That is not your requirement. Okay, your requirement is R followed by S, like this one. Okay, if you make it up to this is final, then only it will accept this one. It will not, but my, if you paired, this is my R, this is my S. Right? So we want the strings of R, then you paired with 0, 0, 1, then that is a string of RS. So that string you need to accept. That's why these are the changes. And this is no more the initial. Initial state is the initial state of R. Okay. So this diagram will tell everything. Which one is the initial state, which one is the final state. Okay. So yes, final remains the same. R initial remains same. But this final becomes is a non-final now. This is also not an initial state. Initial state is this one, first one, right? So if you just remember this diagram for RS, then everything you can write down. All the five components you can write down. Now, let us see the third category, R star. Okay. R star means you know already one machine for R. This is my R machine. Initial is there, final is there, it's already given. And R star means R, all kinds of things are accepted. Okay. So that means if you know, suppose this example, this is my R, suppose this is my R. Okay. My object, if you know a machine for this one, I will make a star. Okay. Can you find out a machine for this? So that means if you already know the smaller machine, what you will do? What you will do? So you start a initial state. It has one initial, one final is there. So you join them by epsilon, right? And make a final state. This is QL. This is the final state. If you want, you can. This is the final state of the proton QL. This is epsilon. So, if I write only this model, then it will only accept R, nothing else. But I want R star. So, for that, I will give a repetition, a loop kind of thing, from final to the initial, means the entire string via epsilon. After processing this, again, if you come back via epsilon, then after processing, you can repeat this. Okay, so this is the machine which will accept any repetition. and you know star is your clean closure. Star is your clean closure, and means it will accept epsilon. R plus is the positive closure. No epsilon is there. So plus two accept epsilon. R star R plus you know the difference. R star means epsilon is accepted. Along with that, all other strings are accepted. R, 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 all are accepted. Okay. So this is the model design for R star. R plus S, this is the model. R S, this is the model. R star, this is the model. Very simple. So you just give a loop, go to the just by epsilon transition, you find out. So all these I am constructing in a phase. Because epsilon move I am giving. So NF epsilon is always easy to construct than NF. But you know the really, in the reality, practically this type of machine doesn't exist. These are all theoretical concepts. But it is very easy to construct a NF epsilon. For everyone, epsilon, I have constructed a machine. A symbol, I have constructed a machine. High is a regular expression, for that I have constructed a machine. If R and S are regular expression and corresponding regular sets are R and S, regular languages are there, that means you know if it is regular language means you know the machine for R and S. If you know these two machines for R plus S and R S and R star, we have constructed the machine. Okay. This is the machine which by using that you can construct your the model, right? And this is very simple because whatever machine is for R, the same will you can use for the bracket has no role, it will not contribute anything. Okay, so two three brackets if you give, then that has some meaning. But only if you know the one language, then you give a bracket, it has no role. So it is automatically that machine, if R is there, R machine is there, the same R machine will work for this one also. Okay? For bracket. There is no change. So for every category, we have given the a design in the base. That means I have proved that for every regular expression, with all definitions, all I am using. All kinds of cases, I have constructed this corresponding NF. Okay. That means for every regular, if you give a regular expression, using this technique, I can find out its NFA with epsilon transition. Right. And you write Q0, 1, Q1. Okay. So using that, I am writing. Okay. Then one, this is for first one. Okay. Then 1 to 0 plus 1. How to do that? Because for one, this is my machine R. Then 0 plus 1. It's better to write it for 0 plus 1 first. Then 1 I'll call it. 0 plus 1 means write this one. Or zero. Okay, this is initial. This is final. This is the machine for zero. This is the machine for one. Okay. Now for 0 plus 1, as per my construction technique, R plus S. What you will do? So these two, you bring here. Okay. The plus means sorry. This is no more the final one. Huh? To use two extra, make them. This is my R, this is my S, okay, and you join them by epsilon. Make this is my final. This is no more final. Huh? This is my final. So this is for 0 plus 1. Okay. Now one machine is this one is my one machine. This is my 0 plus 1 machine. Now 1 into 0 plus 1. Suppose I want NFA for these two. What I'll do? Okay. One is this one, 0 plus 1 is this one. Yes, or 1 is this one, 0 plus 1. So concatenate them. How to concatenate means if you just give an epsilon to this one. This is my complete is my 0 plus 1. So if you want, you can write down here. This is my 1 machine. This is the 0 plus 1 machine. Epsilon. This is my 0. This is my 1. This is my 0 plus 1. We have already constructed. And we have that. This is for 1. This is for 0 plus 1. Right? 1, 0 plus 1. My question is 1 into 0 plus 1. A concatenation. How to do that? Means this one, you put it here. Okay. Then this one. These are all epsilon. This is for 1, this is for 0 plus 1. Now how to combine them? This technique says, first you keep the R machine, then by epsilon you join to S machine. And this is by R machine, then you join them by epsilon. Okay. And this becomes the final, this is my initial. So this is the NFA, NFA epsilon for this string. Now, the question is, so up to this I have constructed. Some 0 plus 1 star, 0 first you construct, machine 1 you construct, 0 plus 1 you construct, or 0 plus 1 already we have constructed, this is 0 plus 1. Isko star kaise banayenge? So if you want 0 plus 1 star, pehle, then isko, you write down that. Epsilon, epsilon, then 0. And then this is already, this is my 0 plus, this is 0 plus 1, okay? Final I am not giving, but I'll change that, that's why I am not giving final. Huh? But here there is a final, right? This is final is there, 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1 start. What I'll do? I'll start a new one, okay? And new initial, new final, okay? First join them by epsilon, because epsilon is also always belongs to this. And one star means it's a repetition. So you join this by epsilon, okay? And this you join them by epsilon. And from final to initial, you join them by epsilon. Right? So this is my, for 0 plus 1 star. Okay, this is a very, you can write, finally you can write the state name, Q1, Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6, Q7, okay. So number of states will increase, that's why I am not writing the name, numbering. Finally I can give some numbers, okay. Now, for 0 plus 1 star, this is my machine. 1 into 0 plus 1, this is my machine, right. Now, question is this concatenation with this one, these two. If you concatenate them, that is also a regular expression. It must correspond to a regular language. Then find it, find NF. So this one, first you write, then you can connect them to here by epsilon. Okay. Then that will give you the 0, because if you concatenate them, this is the model. Just first R machine you keep. Then S machine just join them by epsilon. So if you want 0 plus 1 star, then this model, 1, 0 plus 1, this was your question, okay? This was my question. First 0 plus 1 star I have constructed, 1 into 0 plus 1 I have constructed. Now you have to find a machine for the larger string, another regular expression, just after concatenation, okay? So in a separate page, you keep a copy here, you keep another copy. After that, you just join them. Okay, so first machine, second machine, join them by epsilon. That will be your answer. So I am doing it here. Already I have written. That's why you can join them by epsilon. Okay, and this is no more your final. For the okay, your final is this one. Just you join them by epsilon. And first this one, then this one. Okay, you see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16 states I am using for this machine. And remember, this is my NFA with epsilon transition. This one. Is it clear? This is a algorithmic approach. You can systematically write a program. And that program will give you this diagram. Just following this logic, following this systematic logic, it will based on your operation. If your operation is plus, follow this one. Operation is concatenation, follow this logic. Operation is R star, follow this one. By just three lookup design will give you your machine. Okay. So this will always give you the guarantee that. For every regular expression, you can always find out an NFA with epsilon transition. But the disadvantage part is, it will take more states. So memory is requirement is more for NFA epsilon. And finally, again, NFA epsilon is not my requirement. But for real machine, I need a DFA. That means another logic is required to convert an NFA epsilon to corresponding DFA, or you may go to NFA, then NFA to DFA, whatever, other using all other programs. Okay, so all these programs you can combine, then direct first regular expression you give, your first this program will give you its NFA epsilon, another program from NFA epsilon to NFA will give you the NFA, then another conversion. Subset construction method last class we have discussed, that will give you the corresponding DFA. Okay. In this process, we can find out a regular, a finite automata from a regular expression. It's always possible. I am following particularly for this case, now everything is given in one page. Okay, epsilon phi symbol R plus S, then RS, then R star. Just remember this design. This will tell you for every regular expression, you can find out a machine. Okay, NF. Okay. And one example is given here, 0 plus 1 star, 1, 0 plus 1. You see how systematically, finally, you are getting this. One after another. Okay. For exam point of view, we may not write this one this way. Okay. Directly you can solve if sometimes possible. Most of the times it's possible to solve directly because we are solving the smaller regular expression. But for a very large expression, you really need a basic computer. You have to write a computer program. So for that, this is the logic. Regular expression to NFA epsilon, NFA epsilon to NFA, NFA to DFA. So you can try. There are other questions if you can write down. Convert the following regular expressions to NFA with epsilon transition. Okay, the way we have discussed, you can also follow that just to understand how it is working. On another way also, directly if you can solve. Directly means the way we have discussed this category. Before, without knowing that technique, we have already solved this problem. We have constructed an DFA. Okay. So you can also directly solve this problem, 01 or 101. It will accept only 01 string, its language contains two values. 01 is accepted and 101 is accepted. So for 01, I think you can write down. Okay, can you solve this? 0, 1 plus 1, 0, 1. So if you want, its corresponding language is 0, 1, 2 strings and 1, 0, 1. Only two strings are there. Can you design a DFA? Direct method. If you want to solve direct method, then it's very simple. For every finite things, you can write 0, 1, go to final string. Okay. Then 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, go to the final string, to final string. So this machine will accept 0, 1 and 1, 0, 1. Here I am giving one hint that if it is a finite, if my language is finite, okay, finite means x1, x2, x3, xn is finite, okay. Finite number of strings are there. Okay. Then this approach will also you can use and you can construct it CDFA or NF, whatever. Okay. For x1, x1 is a string, so you can start Q0. Okay. X1, suppose it's a string. You follow that string. After processing, go to the final string. This is for x1 string. Okay. Similar, next you follow for x2 string. Next you follow for x3 string. Okay. This is x3. So if this is finite, so for in this process also you can always construct a finite automaton or a finite automaton. It may be anything. Sometimes it is been because if this starts from 0, 1, 0, this starts from 0, 1, 1, it's a string, then 0 you have to write 0, 1, 0, suppose 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, suppose 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Okay. Suppose third one is your 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0 suppose. Huh? 1, 0, 0. Okay. Can write. This is very simple. But here you can see if you just, this process will give you an NF. An NF. Because by reading one symbol, I am going to two states. More than one state. So that's why I told you NFA construction is always easy. Then using subset construction method, you find its corresponding DF. You can find from NFA to DF. Okay, but remember that if your question is a finite number of strings, 5 strings, 7 strings, 700 strings or 10,000 strings, then it is irregular. Every, you can write down a statement that every finite language is irregular. And proof is this one. You can always construct an NFA if my strings are finite. So, okay, this is it will. This statement will help you in many exams. You can write that every finite the statement can be okay, every finite language. Finite language means language cardinality is finite. Every finite language is regular. This is one result, okay, or one theorem you can write. Important theorem. Every finite language is irregular. It can also be written. It's the same as for every finite language, one can design a finite automaton. Okay. It is also same as for every finite language, one can design a DFA because all finite automata are same. Or you can write, one can design a NFA. Okay. So this is an interesting question. That's why, because this is always true, and you can say simple way to find out that. As I, in most of the exam, your language, whatever is languages are given, there will be infinite, like 0, 1, plus 1, all stuff. Star means is an infinite. Okay. So if it is infinite, then we will try to find out its DFA or NFA. That is actually, those type of questions are, will come for infinite language. But if for finite language example will come, immediately you can easily, it's a single trick. You can, using this trick, you can always find out its corresponding NFA and you can convert it into corresponding DFA also. Okay. But for infinite language, some it is case to, it will depend, depends upon which type of string you are giving. It needs some logic to solve. Okay. But using, if you don't want your own brain, then this is one approach. Okay, using that also you can find out the programming approach. That's right. Computer will do this. Okay. But we, if you use your own brain, you can solve it in a lesser number of time. Directly you can find its DFA. 0, 1, plus 1, then star. You can directly solve this problem also in your, using your previous, already you know whatever way you have solved. Those experience will help you to solve this also directly. Okay. Or any doubt? Or we'll stop today. Okay, I am giving that those as exercise. You can. This is one regular expression. Okay. This is one regular expression. This is another regular expression is given. So, 0 plus 1 star, find its NFA with epsilon transition